The cruise industry continues to push back against the new CDC Level 4 travel warning, advising even those fully vaccinated and boosted not to cruise. Well, it's officially 2022, and that means we have cruise ship restarts to look forward to. All told, there are 32 ships set to begin operations in the new year. Plus, despite almost every single cruise ship being monitored by the CDC, having some COVID on board, cruisers are still excited to hit the high seas. And it's official, a COVID outbreak has ended a cruise. All this coming up on Midships. Hey, hey, welcome to the Midships YouTube channel. I'm your Captain Corey. Thank you so much for stopping by the channel again today. And I'd like to give a warm welcome to all of our brand new subscribers. We've seen a huge jump in subscribership here on the channel over the last couple of weeks. And so I want to be the first to welcome all of you to the Midships family. Thanks so much for hopping on board. Now, of course, if you're a subscriber to the channel or you happen to see yesterday's episode, you already know my opinion that cruising is one of the safest, if not the safest way to travel right now. And having said all that, I was sat down right here yesterday evening drinking a nice warm macchiato when my cell phone buzzed, and it was a text message from someone in the Midships family who's currently cruising aboard Grandeur of the Seas. Long story short, it's coming out that about 2% of the people that got off of Grandeur of the Seas on January 2nd have tested positive for COVID-19. Grandeur of the Seas does operate out of Bridgetown, Barbados, so it's not going to come up on the CDC's naughty list anytime soon. But with that said, I have yet to see 2% of a ship's population test positive for COVID, so it's something to keep an eye on. And I think that's a wonderful transition into our first story coming out of FloridaToday.com. Almost every cruise ship in the U.S. reports COVID cases on board despite precautions. By David Berman, Florida Today. Almost every cruise ship operating in U.S. waters reported recent COVID cases amongst passengers or crew, despite extensive precautions to guard against the spread of the virus, including vaccination requirements, testing, and face covering. The CDC is now advising people to avoid cruising, even if they're fully vaccinated. As of Monday, the CDC had listed 91 ships in yellow status and 3 ships in an orange status. Furthermore, all 10 cruise ships based in Port Canaveral, which is considered to be the world's second busiest cruise port, are currently in yellow status. Generally, ships with a yellow status recently reported at least 0.1% of their passengers having COVID or a COVID-like illness, triggering CDC investigation. And just for example, that would be 5 passengers on a ship with 5,000 or 3 passengers on a ship with 3,000 passengers aboard. And I think that should give us all pause to consider how minute the number of cases really have to be on board a cruise ship to be put into this yellow status. Now, yes, in recent days, and only in recent days, have we started seeing a handful turn into a dozen or maybe even 2 or 3 dozen cases on board a cruise ship. But all in all, since cruising began back in the summer, we've been in the single digits for COVID cases on board almost every single cruise ship, with the exception of a standout few. Hang on a sec, before we get into our next story, it's time to pay a few bills. I'd like to remind you, in the description below this video, there are Amazon affiliate links to some cruise swag that I take with me on every single cruise. Best thing is, most of the cruise swag costs like 10 bucks or less, and just clicking on the links does help support this channel just a little bit. Thank you so much. In addition to the cruise swag links, there is a link to the Midships Instagram account. If you'd like to find us on there and follow us, it's just Midships Cruise. Can't wait to see you guys on the gram. Now back to the news. So it's quite obvious that the Omicron variant is a setback to every industry on land, just like it is a setback to the cruise industry as well. And to be quite honest with you, cruise lines seem to have pivoted quite quickly, and they've really stepped up to handle this new Omicron variant. And with that in mind, Norwegian Cruise Lines is looking to instill more confidence in their cruisers, and they're instituting a new cancellation policy. Let's learn a little more from cruiseradio.net. Norwegian Cruise Lines updates cancellation policy by Sarah Bretz. In recent days, Norwegian Cruise Lines has updated its peace of mind policy to say the following. For new or existing bookings made by January 31st of this year, for any cruise scheduled through May 31st of this year, guests will be free to cancel up to and including on January 31st of this year. Anyone choosing to cancel will receive a full refund in the form of a future cruise credit to be used for a sailing that embarks now through December 31st of this year. Norwegian Cruise Line had previously extended this policy through October of 2021, but now anyone with a cruise booked this month is also protected. Well, so far here in the US, we have not seen any cases where a cruise was completely shut down because COVID got so out of hand on board the ship. But that's not exactly the case for our cruise family over in Europe. I present to you the story of AIDA Nova. From Yahoo News, COVID outbreak ends cruise. The AIDA Nova, with 2,844 passengers and 1,300 crew on board, docked in Lisbon on December 29th while en route to the island of Madeira for New Year's Eve, but was unable to continue her journey after 52 cases of COVID were detected amongst the fully vaccinated crew. Due to the COVID spread on board, the company's protocol was immediately put into action, with those infected who are asymptomatic or displaying light symptoms immediately isolated aboard the ship. Given the circumstances, the cruise line decided to end the cruise and disembark the passengers. And the cruise line plans to transport the passengers home by air travel. AIDA Cruises is a subsidiary of the Carnival Corporation and did not immediately reply to a request for comment on the situation. Footage from Reuters showed passengers still enjoying the afternoon sun on the decks of the ship with their drinks in hand, and local media said the disembarking would begin after 6 a.m. Monday morning. So it would seem the appetite for COVID spread onboard cruise ships is a lot lower over in Europe than it is here in the U.S. 50 cases onboard a cruise ship is something that's happened several times now in the last week or so here. And we're still cruising in the U.S., where you can see now there's a couple stories sort of filtering out about some problems happening with European or German cruise lines. We'll get into that maybe in tomorrow's episode. I don't want to read too many stories from Europe since most of my audience is here in the U.S. So we're going to move on to our next story about the continued pushback from cruisers against this new CDC travel advisory. And this story comes out of Mobile, Alabama. Let's read a little bit more. From News 5 WKRG Mobile County. By Chad Petrie. Cruise industry pushes back after CDC recommendation against cruise travel. Would you rather take a cruise or do something on land? The CDC issued a statement recently advising against cruising, despite your vaccine status. People in the cruise industry, however, argue there are far more risky activities on land, and they say there are plenty of safeguards in place for cruises. It's the advisory that's been a punch to the cruise industry months after they've tried to come back in 2021. The CDC says cruise passengers can still get or transmit COVID, so they advise against cruising, but they don't ban it. However, another travel agent in the Mobile, Alabama area is arguing that cruising is safer than a lot of what we do on land. Andrea Miller with See It All Travel says the following. Everyone's vaccinated. Everyone's tested negative. Why is it scarier than going to the grocery store or going to a football game? Miller went on to say there's still demand for cruising and people are taking the risks into account. Miller said she knows plenty of people age 70 and up that have sailed happily and confidently, and they're not worried. Saying that COVID cases make up a slim number of the majority of people on board a ship, and it's far less than what it would be on land. And to put Andrea Miller, the travel agent currently being interviewed, into context, Miller says she's been on 4 cruises since September of 2021. She said each of the cruises she's been on, there hasn't been a single person who tested positive on the cruise or shortly after. And she thinks the advisory may add to fatigue over health guidelines and recommendations. So Andrea Miller, I agree with you wholeheartedly. Thank you for your support of the cruise industry. And I'd like to take just a second here to go ahead and talk to the other cruise content creators here on YouTube. Right here, we share the same platform. I would challenge you to step up, use your platform, use your voice to talk about how ridiculous this new travel advisory is. I know I've seen many of you here in the space. I watch a lot of your content. And a lot of you are starting to talk about this. And I think we have a snowball that we can really get rolling on this. And we really need to push back against this ridiculous travel advisory. Because quite frankly, in my opinion, an advisory like this is pushing people into a different vacation that is probably going to be less safe for them than just taking a cruise. Now, there's one more story to cover in today's episode. And it's about New Year's on a cruise ship. And the thing is, it's probably going to make you a little bit mad. From Jim Walker's CruiseLawNews.com. Published by Jim Walker, and here's Jim over here on the right. Guests ignore CDC warning and party on cruise ships like it's 1999. Watching videos of raucous cruise guests crowded in interior spaces and partying on ships on New Year's Eve makes one think that the deadly COVID pandemic is somehow over. Notwithstanding recommendations by the CDC not to take a cruise even if you're vaccinated, many thousands of guests crowded together and partied on dozens of huge ships, including the Anthem and Harmony of the Seas. And the article goes on to pin several tweets here, and one of them is a video of a New Year's countdown aboard a Royal Caribbean cruise ship. And you can see, it looks like maybe all of the protocols weren't fully being accepted here on board that ship. So obviously an article and videos like this are not a great look. If you're looking to cruise right now, it's important that you go ahead and follow the protocols when you're on board a cruise ship for other people who want to be able to continue cruising, like myself. If you made it this far into today's episode, why haven't you subscribed to the channel yet? While you're down there, make sure you give a big thumbs up if you can't wait for your next cruise. Thanks so much for stopping by the channel today, and until tomorrow, we'll see ya on the Midships.